Hello guys, I'm Dominic. It's been a while since the last video. As usual, today I will hold another battle between animals. It's the battle between great white shark and saltwater crocodile. Let's begin with the characteristics.
The great white shark could be growing to 20 feet in length and 4,200 pounds in weight at maturity, while adult males saltwater crocodile can reach sizes up to 23 feet in length and weighing 2,200 to 2,600 pounds. So in terms of size, the great white shark is bigger than the saltwater crocodile. The great white has a complete set of jaws with 222 teeth and 45 vertebrae. It also has rows of serrated teeth behind the main ones, ready to replace any that break off. The crocodile has long teeth, with the largest one have been measured at up to 3.5 inch in length. The bite force of great whites is 669 psi, but the bite force of large great white sharks has never been accurately measured. Given their elusive nature and the potential hazards they present, this is hardly surprising. A number of very large unconfirmed great white shark specimens have been recorded. In the 1930s, a 37-foot shark trapped in a herring weir in New Brunswick, Canada, but it truly was a basking shark, as the two have similar body shapes. Shark teeth, which are capable of shearing through flesh and bone alike, are sharp like razor. All they need to do is to grab you and shake their heads, and the teeth will do the job. You can say goodbye to your leg. The crushing force of the saltwater jaw is stronger than the bite force of great whites. Salties are number 2 strongest spiders of the world, 3,700 psi. Only their cousins now crocodile bite harder. Teeth of the crocs are rather made to grab you and to pull you in the water, and then they are drown you using their famous death throw technique. White sharks can live in diverse marine environments and can dive deep. Its auditory is extremely sensitive, can feel one drop of blood in 100 liters of seawater or detect a seal 2 miles away. Crocodile cannot dive deep, but it can go to the shore to hunt. Sharks charge at victims from below, meaning the full mass of the animal is also behind any attack. The hunting methods utilized by saltwater crocodiles are indistinct from any other crocodilian, with the hunting crocodile submerging and quietly swimming over to the prey before pouncing upwards, striking suddenly. Great white sharks can swim at speeds of over 35 miles per hour, but they would find it hard to change direction. The crocodile swims at 15 to 18 miles per hour, but they could change direction easier. In terms of intelligence, I think both are the same. They could use strategy to hunt prey. Weakness of the great white shark. Under having a huge jaw, the great whites don't have the highest bite force. The shark's bite is still adequate enough for killing, but perhaps not quite as deadly as the crocodile's. Its skin was not designed for withstanding a couple of tons of penetrating forces. The great white cannot change direction while swimming easily. Its advantages are could swim faster and bigger than the crocodile. The weaknesses of crocodile are smaller and swim slower than the great white. It has to come back to the air to breathe. Its underbelly is vulnerable. Its advantage is the armor-plated skin, making them pretty tough animals to kill. The crocodile's jaws are designed to clamp down and crush. These bite forces are accurately obtained. A crocodile can't chew its food, so it has very powerful bite specifically designed to slam shut. Then the crocodile would jerk its head or utilize a death throw, which would tear off limbs or chunks of the prey, or quite literally crush an animal's skull. From the above analysis, I could say that the winning rate of the crocodile will be higher than that of the great white. It would be 60% for the crocodile and 40% for the great white shark.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you like.